Good morning, student. I am Sandhya Kumari Lanthi, Senior Lecturer Electrical. Today I am going to explain about maximum power transfer theorem. This theorem is to find out the load resistance for which there will be a maximum amount of power transfer. This theorem states that a resistive load being connected to a DC network receives maximum amount of power when the load resistance is equal to the internal resistance, or you may call it as a Thevenin's resistance. Let us consider a DC network. The internal resistance, also called as Thevenin's resistance, and the current in the circuit I can be find out using the formula V divided by RTH plus RL. While the power delivered to the resistive load is PL I square into RL, you may write it as V divided by H plus RL whole square into RL. This power can be maximized by varying RL and stop. Hence, maximum power delivered can be maximized by dPL by dRL equals to 0. The formulas we will get E by D RL of E by H plus equals to 0. We can get maximum power by when dPL by dRL equals to 0. Then we can derive it PL formula V by V RTH plus RL whole square into RL. This formula we can put it here, and using the formula of D by DX of U by V, that is V into DU by DX minus U into DV by DX divided by V square. We just put this formula here and make it equals to 0. Here V is RTH plus RL whole square and U is V square RL. In this formula, we can get just multiplying this RTH plus RL square into 0, this will be 0. And the numerator becomes 0. That is RTH plus RL square into V square minus V square RL into 2 RTH plus RL equals to 0. Then we take common here V square and RTH plus RL. We take it as common, and the equation becomes V is V square RTH plus RL into RTH plus RL minus 2 RL equals to 0. Here, by dividing this with 0, we can get the only parameter is RTH minus RL equals to 0, and it becomes RTH equals to RL. Maximum power is V divided by RTH plus RTH. Instead of RL, we can put RTH whole square into RTH, becomes V square, this is 2 RTH. V square divided by 4 RTH. This is the power consumed by the load. And now the power transferred by the source is also inch, and the total power is 2 into V square by 4 RTH equal to V square divided by 2 RTH. Now the efficiency becomes output power by input power into 100. Input is always 50%. Now we can discuss steps for solution of network using maximum power transfer theorem. First step. Remove load resistance and find Thevenin resistance, that is RTH, from the open circuited load terminal. Step 2, as per maximum power transfer theorem, we get RL equals to RTH. Now for step 3, we have to find out the Thevenin's voltage from the open circuited load terminal. And we, using the formula in the step 4, we can get maximum power, that is V0 square divided by 4 RTH. Let us understand this maximum power transfer theorem using an example. Here the question is, find the value of R in the circuit of figure such that maximum power transfer takes place, and also find the value of maximum power here in this circuit. Here it is, load resistance is R. As we know, for step 1, we have to remove load resistance and calculate Thevenin's resistance. For calculating Thevenin resistance, we just have to follow the rules. That is, so deactivating the sources. Here we have 3 sources, 1 current source and 2 voltage source. For deactivating current source or voltage source, we have to replace it by its internal resistances. Or we may just open circuit the current sources and short circuit the voltage sources. Then we get the circuit as this. And from the open circuited load terminal, we have to calculate Thevenin's resistance. We are looking from this side, from XY, we find that 2 ohm is parallel with 5 ohm and 10 ohm. 5 and 10 ohm in series. So just calculating, we will get RTH equals to 2 parallel with 10 plus 5, then 2 parallel with 15, then using the formula we will get 30 by 17, that is equal to 1.765 ohms. And for step 2, we have to calculate the load resistance or R. As we know, for maximum power transfer theorem, the load resistance is equal to Thevenin's resistance. So ultimately, the load resistance will be 1.765 ohms. Next come to step 3. Step 3 is using for calculating Thevenin's voltage, that is calculated from the open circuited load terminal. And this can be calculated using various methods like your nodal analysis, mesh analysis, or you may use source transformation techniques. Here we use the source transformation techniques to make this current source into voltage source. And the circuit becomes like this. This becomes 20 volt in series with the same resistance, that is 10 ohm. Now we can apply this loop equation. In this loop, applying KVL, we can get 20 minus 10i minus 5i minus 6 minus 2i equals to 0. And by equating this, we can get I equals to 14 by 17 ampere. And for calculating voltage across AB, we just have to multiply it with the resistance. Current into resistance will be the voltage. And for calculating voltage across XY, we just have to add this 10 volt. Here we can add 10 volt with the voltage across AB. And we will get the voltage is 11.65 volt. And in step 4, we can calculate maximum power using the formula VOC square divided by 4 RTH. Substituting the values of VOC as 11.65 and the value of RTH 1.765, we can get the power as 19.22